Good evening.
My name is Lafteli and I will be your moderator for this evening class. Welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a non-profit, non-denominational religious and scientific research organization dedicated to showing you proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of his eternal purpose, pattern and plans, operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio in the year 1931. We were later on incorporated in the state of California in the year 1958. Since that time, we have established branch schools throughout the United States, Canada, Africa, and several other foreign countries throughout the world. Our local IDMR Kingston branch school was established in Kingston, Jamaica in the year 1988, and our Spanish one branch in the year 1994. Now let me introduce to you two of the officials of our Spanish one branch. We have our Dean, Dr. Donna Mitchell, and our President, Dr. Leon Jack. In this school, we teach by the true, correct, and original name and title of our Heavenly Father, the Word, our Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of our Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted with Lord. The true title for the Word, our Son, is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted with God. The true name of the Holy Spirit, manifested in our ultimate physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted with Jesus Christ. No, Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are Lords many and Gods many. But we now know that each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means that Elohim is a title that our Heavenly Father Yahweh chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but an erroneous name. A manner investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia will show proof that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any characters or letters in your alphabet that would produce the sound made by the letter J. And neither was the letter J nor English alphabet until some 1400 years after the death, burial, and resurrection of Yahshua the Messiah. Therefore, making such names as Jesus, Jah, and Jehovah impossible and incorrect rendering the true and correct name of our Heavenly Father and His Son. Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Now this is our Mosaic chart, and may I direct your attention. Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state He is incomprehensible, inscrutable, invisible, and inconceivable. Yahweh is the ultimate source, is the infinite and immaculate substance, is the limits and bounds of everything. Now here we have Yahweh, symbolized on this chart as a cloud. However, Yahweh is not a cloud. Yahweh merely chose a cloud to symbolize or to depict himself because a cloud has no particular descriptive shape or form. We have John, this orange fiery cloud, all on the edge of this chart to show proof, or that everything on this chart abides within the cloud. In like manner does everything in the universe abide within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Now Yahweh, that man, could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, he took on shape and form, right with himself as Elohim. This is the Word, our Son, the super incorporeal being of the great heavenly anthropomorphic being. This is having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. In this form, he can only be seen in divine vision and understood in divine revelation. Later on, this self-same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plain as Yahshua the Messiah, who the world erroneously called Jesus Christ. Now, there's only one name given unto salvation, and we must know this name. So the simple yet intelligent question we should ask ourselves, what was the name of the Savior during the time he walked the earth plain? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of our Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach on the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it's Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh, the children of Israel out of Egypt, Yahweh found Moses on top Mount Sinai and showed him this threefold pattern in a vision. Yahweh later instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The pattern is consisted of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court round about. These three compartments make up this one tabernacle pattern. In our schools, we go about showing you proof of everything in the universe is made and operated according to the structure and function of this threefold pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes this pattern. In our schools, we have 10 primary constitutional aims and objectives, and they are as follows. One is to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and as he actually exists. Two is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, with a distinction of race, nationality, creed, sex, class, or color. Three is to investigate the unexplained spirit law, or the so-called laws of nature and the powers latent in man. Four is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures comparative to religion, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Five is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Six is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose, operating through the dispensation and ages. Seven is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the dragon, the devil, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensation of time. Eight is earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered to the sons of the children of Yahweh. Now it is made known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained. There is no other name given among men whereby man must be saved, save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. 10 is inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watch when it speaks and our slogan is speaking. For this evening, I give my lecture. We have prayer by Dr. Irving Grant. And our scripture lesson is taken from Psalms 23, read by Dr. Leandra.
As far as I might in prayer, eternal Father Yahweh and Yahshua. The concept is a great privilege of Father Yahweh to invite us during another evening to continue to learn the purpose, pattern, and plan of salvation. To come to a profound knowledge of your Father Yahweh as it really is and actually exists. We truly grateful unto you, Yahweh's great teaching. I would just ask that you continue to open our hearts and mind that we can learn more of thee, we can perceive of thee more continuously. And thank God to keep us in the faith, I pray to your Father, yeah. God, you know, say, let us be well in the bin, man, to keep us. So we ask that we humbly to keep us in the faith, I pray to you. And thank God to bless us with vision and revelation of Yahshua Messiah, I pray to your Father. I will just ask that at this time, yeah. Anyone and you're coming, we put the desire into to come and learn of thee. Yes, let's step that day to my come and learn. And we know we are being blessed, Father, yeah. To become your son and your children. We can't say we are your children, yeah. So we keep thanks to that. Thanks to all. I would truly give thanks to you for the resurrection of your son Yahshua Messiah, because the Yahshua resurrected in our hearts and mind, we surely lack. So we give thanks that Yahshua Messiah resurrecting us and keeping us of fire and blessing us with knowledge. So we continue to give thanks unto you, Oya, for that. And we just continue to give thanks and praise to that word again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Good evening, friends.
Good evening. I'm
reading Psalm 22 from the Holy Bible. Yahweh is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of Yahshua forever.
Hallelujah.
Our scripture reading for tonight is in Dr. Leon Jack, and our scripture for tonight is in the Ordeal of the Lecture.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm going to another spiritual lecture given to you by the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research Incorporated. We are a school and we are not a church. And in this school, we go about showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, Elohim, and the Son, our Savior. Prior to this vision and revelation, we were told that Lord God and Jesus Christ, Jah, Allah, Buddha, Krishna, was the Savior, and that we have to do physical works to be saved. Contrary to this vision and revelation, we now learn and understand and know that Yahweh Eliyashua the Messiah is the Savior, and that it is by grace we are saved through faith, not of works, that any man should boast. The gift of Yahweh is eternal life through Yahshua the Messiah. We didn't know anything about the law and the prophets. We didn't know anything about the tabernacle pattern. We didn't know that the Messiah mission was to fulfill. Get me Matthew 5:17. We thought that he came to establish or set up a Christian example for us to follow. We later learn and understand, and we understood too, that Yahshua was not a Christian, because Christian means to be Christ-like. And Yahshua is not Christ. Yahshua is the Messiah, the resurrected Son of Yahweh, our Savior. So they have the names wrong and they have the doctrine wrong. Doctrine is a body of principle. So the Messiah was sent by Yahweh as a gift. In Luke 1:26, then you read the other scripture. I didn't know that we have witnesses in the Bible in the creation in our physical bodies to prove the existence of the Creator. I heard about Lord God and Jesus Christ. It was never proven to me that Jesus Christ is the Savior. What King James did in the translation, his scholars, from the original scroll, the manuscript scroll, when he came across the name Yahweh translated to a common title, Lord, when he came across the pluralistic title that Yahweh gave to himself. Yahweh gave himself this name, he gave himself this title, and he named his son Yahshua. King James, who was a mere man, took it upon himself with his scholars to substitute Yahweh for Lord, substitute Elohim for God, and substitute Yahshua for Jesus Christ. Let me tell you this. That was one of the worst mistakes that was ever made throughout eternity and present. Throughout time, up to this very day, is a grave error. You hear people talking about people going up to space and human error and this ship exploding and what have you. This is even worse. Very bad. Take for example, if you walk out in the town, and where Martin Street is, I switch Martin Street to King Street. Or Kingston, I change Kingston to Spanish though. And I change Montego Bay from Montego Bay to St. Thomas. And I keep doing that. You are coming from America, you are coming to Spanish though. What would that mean?
You name Kingston.
Then I say to you, it doesn't matter. Because Kingston is Spanish and Spanish is Kingston. I come up to you and say, it doesn't matter, I sent you two names. No, you'd be frightened out of your wits. Because if you sent you two names, how would you find your way? You're lost. Take for example, you go in the supermarket, and everything in the supermarket is nameless. You don't even work. But there are no names. So, you get a paycheck and you don't see a name on the paycheck. Then later on, you see my name on your paycheck. Then you say, it doesn't really matter. Would you say that? It matters. So this teaching has revolutionized the world.
True.
And we are witnesses to what we are saying.
Yeah, sure.
All right, read those scriptures.
Luke, chapter 1:26.
Yes.
And in the sixth month.
No, he says in the sixth month. Which month is the first month? They told us that it's January. No, but there's a sacred calendar. And there's a Gregorian calendar. There are many calendars. But which calendar Yahweh is using?
Sacred.
Read, he said in the sixth month, read.
Yes. Gabriel.
The angel Gabriel. So the name was given by an angel. You are your angel, righteous angels, making mistakes. And the angel said, send you two names. Micah 5:2 says, out of Bethlehem you should come forth that is to be ruler in Israel. Lord is British. Did the Bible say we're coming from London? God is Assyrian and German. Did he say any of these nationalities? Jesus derived from Ea, the Babylonian water god. Zeus, the supreme god of the Greeks. Christ come from Krishna or Christos, an Hindu idol son god. Read.
Yes. Luke 1:26.
Yes.
And in the sixth month.
In the sixth month.
The angel Gabriel was sent from Yahweh unto a city of Galilee.
No, the angel Gabriel was sent from Yahweh to Assyria of Galilee,
named Nazareth.
So that sounds like Israel to me. Named Nazareth. He didn't say Africa. He didn't say London. He didn't say Greece. He said Nazareth. Read.
Luke 1:27. Mm-hmm. To a virgin.
To a virgin.
Exposed to a man whose name was Joseph.
All right, jump down to where he gave the name. That verse. He said, thou shalt conceive.
Verse 36.
Yes. And bear a son. And thou shalt call his name Yahshua. Now let's go back to that very moment in time. You haven't found it? Verse 16, verse 36. Where it says, she shall conceive and bear a son.
Verse 31.
Yes.
And thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son.
And bring forth a son. No, they didn't have any X-ray vision. So it's a true prophet speaking. Because she brought forth a male child. Read.
And shall call his name Yahshua.
Names.
No, name. N-A-M-E.
It doesn't matter. It matter?
Yes.
I think the angel gave one name.
One name, Yahshua.
I say, you can call him Jesus sometimes or Allah or Buddha.
And thou shalt call his name Yahshua.
Thou shalt call his name Yahshua, plus 72.
No.
You see what? You see all these things about Jesus Christ, Allah, Buddha, and 72 names. Let me tell you something. It's propaganda. Propaganda is a terrible thing and it's demon. One person come and say something and the other speak it up and tell. And you see that I call it like the negation. They don't speak it up and write on it. But you see, a real man could come and tell you something, but he could tell you something good too. But it's the spirit of negation. Hell, death, and the grave. Now, read all the scripture, Papa. That's enough. Thank you.
Matthew 5:17.
Yes.
Think now that I'm come to destroy the law of the prophets.
No, Isaiah 8:20, Mitchell, after this. He said, think not that I'm come to destroy the law.
Or the prophets.
The law is the first child of our Bible from Genesis to Deuteronomy. And the prophets are from Yahushua to Malachi. Yahushua said he didn't come to destroy the law or the prophets. Did he say he didn't come to destroy the Egyptian book of the day? 5, 6, 7 book of Moses.
The law and the prophets.
So Yahshua spoke about the law and the prophets, but there are other books in negation who can prove that Yahweh wrote the original scriptures. Read. So he spoke about the law and the prophets. He didn't say, don't bring to me about any Egyptian book of the dead and the 6 and 7 books of Moses. He said to the law and the prophets, and he spoke about the scriptures.
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
To establish.
To fulfill.
Did he say he came to establish?
No, to fulfill.
What do you mean you not fulfill any of it?
Finish, complete, join in.
Is it the same as established?
No.
Or is it the opposite?
Opposite.
Is there any other place in the Bible or places where he said he came to fulfill?
No.
Could you find another one? Get me Matthew to the 3rd chapter with the baptism. Well, we have once there he said he came to fulfill. So fulfill means to finish, complete, bring to an end as of a promise. In the King James Version of the Bible, which chapter or verse in that Bible said he came to establish? Could you read it?
Not here.
Or set up a Christian example?
Not here.
It's not in the book?
No.
But they say that he was setting a Christian. Is there another propaganda? All right. Where in the Bible said that you should have grape juice and crackers?
Nothing.
For the Passover?
Nothing.
You can't find it. That's another propaganda. Where in the Bible that it says a Gentile should be baptized in water to be saved? Or any man should be baptized? Where in the Bible does it say that the Gentiles receive the Ten Commandment law? It's not in the Bible?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
Where in the Bible it says that Jesus is recorded in the book of Moses? Are in the prophets? The name Jesus Christ or Jesus? It's not in Genesis. It's not in Exodus. But John 5:46, according to the King James, say, for you believe Moses would have been in it, for Moses would have been. How can you write about a man without writing his name? And you're saying that Jesus Christ is not in the beginning of the book? It's not in the middle of the book? So where is it there? At the back? at the back. But didn't the message say he is the same yesterday, today, and forever? And Moses, he said that Moses wrote of him. But you will not find, now when you come to these classes, you cannot be biased. All the preconceived ideas you have to share with them and come with an open mind. Now, we were told that Jesus Christ is the Savior. In John 5, 46, the Messiah said, "For as you believe Moses, you
have believed me, for he wrote of me."
For Moses what?
Wrote of me.
We're speaking there according to the King James Version.
Jesus.
King James, according to the King James. Jesus Christ said that Moses wrote of him. Well, I have $5,000. If you find Jesus Christ in Moses is writing, I give it to you. I know I'm going to keep my five. But who made that statement originally? Yahshua.
Yeah,
you see, the devil is again caught in his craftiness.
Yeah.
Because it's Yahshua made that statement. I didn't check Moses is writing. Did he write about Yahshua?
Yes,
you wrote about Joshua, and they call him Joshua. Is there a book of Jesus Christ in the Bible?
No.
Is there a book of Joshua in the Bible? Yes. They call the book of Joshua.
Yes.
Can you find the name Joshua right through the Bible from Genesis to Revelation?
Yes.
So you say he came in the volume of the book it is written of him. That's Peluda away. So the book is written about him. He should be all over, his name should be right through the book. So his book is back, his name is back here in Genesis, in Numbers, right through the book. There's a book in the prophecy about Exodus 17 and 9. Yahoshua 10 and 12, the book of Yahoshua, which they call the book of Joshua, which we could show you right through the name Yahshua is writing. So something is wrong. Something is definitely wrong. Something is amiss. What is wrong? Because Moses King James substituted the names. I forgot. I forgot to fix it right through the book. So he took it out, and then when he reached down there at the back of the book, no, instead of continuing the same thing, he put Jesus Christ. What if I write a letter to you, Mr. Visitor? And in the beginning of the letter, I am calling myself Donna. At the end of the letter, I start to say Maria. Would you be confused? I change my name fully, Maria Brown. And it's one letter, and then I change it all. Let me tell you something. When you have lost the name, you have lost your identity.
That's right.
Salvation is in Yahshua. Because he is his name. Alright, let's continue.
Yeah, you want to finish Matthew, right?
Yes.
For verily I say unto you,
yes,
till heaven and earth pass, one yard or one tittle shall not pass
from the law
till it be fulfilled.
So he repeated himself that his mission was to fulfill. He found another fulfill?
Yes. With the use of the word finish.
Yes.
John chapter 5.
And that's on Matthew, the third chapter.
Matthew 3.
Where it says, suffer it to be so now, John 4 doesn't become a us to fulfill. And I can find several scriptures. Read this again.
John chapter 5, verse 36.
Yes.
But I have greater witness than that of John.
He said, I have greater witness than that of John.
Yeah,
yes.
For the works which the Father had given me to finish.
The Father gave him the works of the law to finish.
Or fulfill.
The
same works I do, and they bear witness of me that the Father has sent me.
All right.
Matthew 3 and 15.
Finish, Michel?
Yes.
All right.
Continue.
All right. Yeah. So the works that the Father gave him to finish, the works of the law. So he was fulfilling the works of the law. Isaiah 8 and 20, Michel, after that. Read there.
And Yahshua answered, said unto him, permit it to be so now.
When he was being baptized, he said, permit it to be so now.
For does it become in us to fulfill all righteousness?
All righteousness of this old covenant.
Then he permitted.
So you mean you don't understand the difference between fulfill and establish? He said his mission was to fulfill all righteousness. All right, let me ask for example. What about baptism? Was the Messiah the one who set up water baptism?
No, no,
no.
Water baptism was set up
with
Moses and Yahushua back there at the Red Sea. Because the Messiah was born until in the fulfillment.
Right.
So his mission was to fulfill all that was set up back here before he came. So they were set up before. Was the Messiah the first man baptized that day?
No, man. No.
So if I am setting an exam, who should do it first?
Me.
When you read Matthew the 3rd chapter, it says all the region around Jordan, the people were being baptized before the Messiah reached and received. So baptism was a custom. It's something that they always do before the Messiah came. So when he came on the scene, his mission was to bring that to an end and set up a spiritual baptism, which is the baptism of the soul. All right, read.
Yeah. Isaiah chapter 8, verse 20.
Yes, Luke 24, 25.
To the law.
No, he says, to the law.
And to the testimony.
So the law is the first 5 books of our Bible, and the testimony is from Yahushua to Malachi. Then we have the fulfillment, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, then the spiritual reality. Now, if you're going to say anything about the Creator, you have to go to the law and to the testimony. Read.
Isaiah 8:20 continues.
Yes.
If they speak not according to this word.
If they speak not according to this word, who is Yahweh Elohim.
It is because there is no light in them.
So you have to use the witnesses. It is because there is no light or Holy Spirit in them. Read on.
Luke 24:25.
Yes.
Then he said unto them.
Then Yahshua said unto them.
Oh fools and slow of heart.
He didn't call them a fool to insult them or to instruct them. He said, oh fools and slow of heart.
To believe all that the prophet has spoken.
To believe all that the prophet has spoken.
That Yahshua the Messiah will suffer these things.
So he suffered death and a burial and he resurrected gloriously. Read.
And to enter into his glory.
And to enter into his glory.
And begin at Moses.
So he took them back to the writing of Moses. So it's important to begin at the beginning of the book. No, you ever read a novel or read a novel and you start at the back of the book?
No.
What do you do when you read a novel?
Start from the beginning.
So you say you must begin at the beginning of the book. Listen to what he says.
And begin at Moses.
So he say you must begin at Moses.
And all the prophets.
And go through all the prophets.
You expound unto them in all
and you should expound unto the us or them.
In all the scriptures.
In all the scriptures.
Things concerning himself.
So he's in Moses' writing?
Yes.
Why did he say, go to Moses and expound the things concerning Yahshua? That's what he said, you know.
Yeah.
So Jesus not in there, so it couldn't be Jesus. So it got to be Yahshua. Read on that.
And he said unto them.
He said unto them.
These are the words that I speak unto you while I was yet with you.
Yes, read.
That all things must be fulfilled.
Stop right here. That all things should be
fulfilled.
Change fulfill to establish. Let's try a thing.
All things should be established.
So all things should be fulfilled. Read on.
Okay.
You have to give your undivided attention if you want to learn something.
Which were written in the law of Moses.
He said all things should be fulfilled.
Yes, which were written in the law of Moses.
Which were written where?
In the law of Moses.
And what was written in the law of Moses?
Sabbath.
Water baptism, Passover, circumcision,
Feast.
Ten Commandment law. You're sure you said the things that were written in the law of Moses should be?
Moses.
What Bible are you reading from?
The Holy Name I read.
Where's the King James Version?
Right.
Read it here from the King James Version. Because I want the pastor not reading the writing.
No.
Because all the things that were written in the law of Moses should be fulfilled. Who could get fulfilled definition on your phone? Let me see, fulfill means to establish. You have service on your phone? Somebody. You have a dictionary? This is a school. Mitchell, you have a dictionary?
No, not too much.
Because it says, the Bible is saying right there that all the things that were written in the law of Moses should be fulfilled. Finish. Complete. Bring to an end as of a plan. So I need a definition of fulfill. What are you looking from the chair?
Luke 24.
Verse
25.
From the King James. You haven't found it?
Yes, it's right.
That part here. Read that same. What verse is that?
44.
Verse 44. Listen to 44 from the King James Version.
Reading it just as it is.
Yes.
And he said unto them.
And he said unto them.
These are the words which I spake unto you.
So Yeshua was saying, these are the words that I spake unto you.
While I was yet with you.
While I was walking with you.
That all things must be fulfilled.
That all things must be fulfilled.
Which were written in the law of Moses.
Which were written where?
In the law of Moses.
Yeshua, you see the law of Moses?
Yes.
Give me an example of what was written in the law of Moses.
Passover
feast.
Exodus.
Sabbath.
12:8.
Baptism.
Foot washing.
Tithes and offering.
Unleavened bread.
And who said it? The Messiah?
Roasted lamb.
Who said that? The Messiah?
Yes.
But the pastor said otherwise. The pastor is saying something in contrary to that. So you believe the pastor, you believe the Messiah. You have to make the decision tonight, you know. Like it is important. The Messiah said, all are some things.
All things.
All things.
What's the definition of all?
Exclusive of God.
I wonder if the Sabbath should be kept.
No.
Only for the soul, not physical.
It says, all things that were written, read back that again.
Luke 24 verse 44, King James is rendered.
Yes.
And he said unto them.
Yeshua was speaking. This is from Yeshua's mouth.
These are the words which I spake unto you.
These are the words which I spake unto you.
While I was yet with you.
While I was yet with you.
That all things must be fulfilled.
All things must be fulfilled. Exodus 20 and 1. All things must be fulfilled.
Which were written in the law of Moses.
Which were written in the law of Moses.
As in the prophets.
And in the prophets.
As in the Psalms.
And in the Psalms.
Concerning me.
Concerning me. But we couldn't find Jesus in the law and the prophet. But the Messiah just said that the things that were written in the law and the prophet concern him. But we can't find Jesus Christ. So it wasn't Jesus speaking. The devil is again caught in his craftiness. Because it says, which were written in the law of Moses, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. I only see Yeshua in the law of Moses. I don't see Jesus Christ. So the devil is again caught in his craftiness. Anybody found the definition of fulfilling?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
The first point is to achieve or to realize. The second point is to complete.
Complete.
Period of time or a piece of work.
Complete. Not to establish. So if this building is completed, it is finished. If I am digging the foundation, that's established. I'm setting up. So it's two different things. To complete, that's a key point. So all this time the Messiah was setting a Christian example for us to follow. And he was setting up. And when he was at the cross, he said it is finished. He brought the works of the physical law to an end. Because he said all of them must be fulfilled. When he was at the cross, what did he say?
It is finished.
He finished fulfilling the works.
Yeah.
And then he brought them to an end. And set up spiritual laws. One spiritual law. And he nailed all of the old covenant to his cross. And Yeshua is the law of the spirit of life. All right.
Exodus 20 and 1.
Listen to this now.
And Elohim speak all these words say.
Yes.
I am Yahweh thy Elohim.
He says that I am Yahweh thy Elohim.
Which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage.
Thou shalt have no Elohim beside to fulfill.
Jump down to verse 7 for to save
verse
time.
7.
Just look at some of the things.
Thou shalt not take away the name of Yahweh thy Elohim to bring it to naught.
Alright, verse 8.
8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
And we could go on and on and on. Now, the reason why he said remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Because the Sabbath was given in the 16th chapter of Exodus. And he was speaking to a particular group of people. He wasn't speaking to the entire world. So but that Sabbath was brought to an end. Mm-hmm. Baptism was set up at the Red Sea. It was brought to an end. Because Yahshua is the reality of all these, everything that was back here, Yahshua is the reality.
Right.
This was a shadow, and Yahshua is the reality. Alright, we're going to run the name, then we'll get into some of those things. The Holy Name Scripture. 47 of Luke 24. And that repentance
and remission of sins
says, and that repentance,
yes,
and remission of sins,
yes,
should be preached in his name.
He used to go to church and water baptize.
Should be preached in his name.
But where is that scripture that says that repentance and remission of sin is to go to church and keep the commandment of God? Can you, is it in the book?
Not in the book.
I didn't know these things, you know, the pastors are really wicked. I didn't know that that wasn't in the book until I came down here. No, you need to listen to the Creator. Because he says, I'll give you pastors after my own heart. That will feed you with knowledge and understanding. These pastors come and they spend all that proper here and there. But the Messiah says that repentance, or you get remission of sin. Everybody is going to church, they say that they want to get forgiveness of sin. And the pastor send them in the opposite direction and say that he's following the Bible. Then if you're following the Bible, why can't I find what you're promoting in the Bible? And the Gentiles did not receive a physical law. And that's what the book says, Romans 2:14 after this. And then we're going to run the name. What it says there, Dr. Mitchell?
And that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name.
He said that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in Yahshua's name.
Among so all if you know nations. That,
among all nations. So if you don't have the right name.
Jerusalem.
If you don't have the right name, how are you getting repentance and remission of sin? Suppose you have to take some garlic for something. And then I say to you, it doesn't matter. Just eat a piece of pear. Mm-hmm. It matters.
Yes, definitely.
Yahshua says that repentance and remission of sin. How many names is it in?
One.
In his names?
Name.
So it's one name. When we say to the people of the world, Yahshua is the true name of this name. I hear them. Yes, man. Yahshua is the original name. They know the original name, you know?
Right?
Yes, man. Yahshua is the original name. So since Yahshua is the original name, what is Jesus? I remember when your pastor announced him, and he said, yes, man. Yeah, Yahshua. That's the true and original name. But the modern name is Jesus. Says who? Find me that scripture that says it. The modern name is Jesus. Yahweh said in Revelation that he'll give a new name because he gave a new name with the new covenant. Because under the old covenant it was the name Yahweh. And that's why Matthew 17 chapter Yahshua says when he revealed on the mountain of transfiguration, he said, tell the vision to no man until I be raised from the dead. Don't tell any man that I am Yahshua. Because he had to fulfill the old covenant in the name Yahweh. And establishing the new covenant in the name Yahshua. So anything you are saying, we are keeping our fingers in the book. It's only a liar come with propaganda and doesn't have any witnesses. They just come and say that word about. No, no, no. We are going to yield to the lines and let the chips fall where they may. Keep our fingers in the book. And that's why Yahweh documented the witness. And that is great. Is that supreme intelligence?
Hallelujah.
Because he knew that the devil would come up and us with propaganda without the answers. So we have the witnesses and we are going to get in the creation and show you that the name is written really in you. And if you lost your name in this physical creation and the police officer hold you out there, you can't tell him your name. The people have amnesia and they go on the road. You know, for many years they are placed in infirmaries. Why? Because you're lost. And then what you call, they have lost, they can't tell your name, they can't tell you. So in this life, taking the natural to understand the spiritual, you use your name to identify yourself. Then can you imagine if you go over nameless? Just imagine yourself nameless in this creation. The chaos and the confusion. Yeah, the airport, you can't give your name. In your passport, there's somebody erase their name. So if you don't have the name for your soul, who is Yahshua the Messiah? Same as how you need your identity in this natural life. Job 22:8 says there is a spirit in man. And Yahweh inspires that spirit. Such is by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit that man lives. What, who are what sustain that spirit man? Which is the greater man, the physical man or the inside, the outside man?
The spirit man.
Who Who do you think Yahweh is saving?
The spirit man.
The spirit man or the flesh? Whatever question then. Yahweh is saving the flesh or the spirit?
Spirit.
You sure about that?
Sure.
So why you go down to the church to baptize your flesh?
Flesh and blood cannot come.
You mean this one can be baptized?
No.
Why you think you said can be baptized? This one can be baptized? No, you want to be it?
Not with the water.
Yeshua.
So are you baptizing soul?
Yeshua.
Get to the living water and then we'll let us run the name and the
gospel.
Listen to this.
Romans 2.
Alright, read that and then go
Romans
to the
Romans chapter 2 verse 28. For he is not an Israelite or Hebrew or Jew.
Yes.
Who is one outwardly.
14.
Neither is that circumcision which is outward in the flesh. Mm-hmm. But he is an Israelite, who is one inward.
So we are the true Israelite, inward.
And spirit. Circumcision is that of the heart.
And the circumcision is that of the heart.
In the spirit.
In the spirit.
And not in the letter.
And not in the letter.
Whose praise is not of men.
Yes.
But of Yahweh.
But of Yahweh. 2:14. For when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things that are written in the law.
These, having not the law, are a law unto themselves.
So the Gentile did not receive a physical law, they received a spiritual law, which is Yahweh. So I was speaking about this, the spirit in man. And you say that spirit is sustained and kept alive?
Yes.
How is a soul sustained? How is it fed? Is it alive?
Yes.
Is the spirit in us alive?
Yes.
By whom or by what is it sustained?
Yahshua, knowledge. Yeah, word.
So when you go down to the church and baptize your body, is that looking in the wrong direction?
Yeah.
Do they need a baptism of a physical body?
No.
They claim it's an outward manifestation of inward grace. That's a stupid thing to say.
Ignorance.
It's really an outward manifestation of inward ignorance. Because if I go to the doctor and I say, doctor, my head, right here hurts. And the doctor take up my foot and say, don't answer, just no. Is that looking in the wrong direction?
Yes.
First thing I said, well, this doctor is a crazy man. And I said, doctor, is my head right here. And he's still spinning around my foot. I said, oh, your foot all right. But Yahweh says, the soul that sinned, it shall die. Isn't that so?
Yeah.
Did he say the body that sinned, it shall die?
No.
You notice how the church you see a cross, and in the graveyard you see a cross. Mm-hmm.
Dead people.
Their carcass is there. Mm-hmm. It's a tomb. We don't apologize. It's a graveyard. Oh, you know it's a graveyard. They are carnivorous. Carnivorous of the flesh. And they are carnal minded. Mm-hmm. So their works are manifested. Works of the flesh. So they are in the flesh all the time. And that's why, when Yeshua was walking, you know what Yeshua said to the Christians? You are white walls of sepulchres, full of dead man's souls. It's a pretty way to call them graves. Still right here, look at the big church around there. There's a cross and the lamp. And there are physical graves in there. Why you know it's a grave? You have to baptize this down here, this body. You have to wash this physical. You have to eat physical bread. Which part of your soul eat physical bread? So if you drink a whiskey, my soul drink whiskey.
No,
sir. So only get some, your soul to drink something. So I mean, if I drink water, my soul is drinking water.
No.
So if I go to the beach and swim, my soul is swimming too.
No.
Yeah, he always says, get me Job 32:8 after you finish reading that.
You want John?
Finish up those scripture then Job 32:1.
John 7:27.
Yes.
In the last day, that great day of the feast.
Yes.
Yahshua stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink.
Read.
He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Rivers of what?
Living water.
You know, when I came down here, I heard about that rivers of living water. I didn't know the pastors are in pastors. Didn't tell me anything about that river of living water. That is the water that washes soul. And your pastor can't handle that.
But this spake he of the Spirit.
But this spake he of the Holy Spirit.
Which they that believe on him should receive.
But he that come to Yahshua must believe that he is.
Yes.
Yeshua no one ever seen those people that wash his soul. It's a gift. For Yahweh is a loved one that he gave. Yeshua is a gift. Your physical life was a gift. So your spiritual life is a gift. Did your pastor baptize you for you to get saved? Have your physical life? Did you have to be a tithe and offering to get your physical life? Did you have to go to church to get your physical life? Your physical life is a gift. Let me tell you something. Yahshua says all power is given unto him in heaven and in earth. He has the power unto salvation, and the power unto resurrection, and the power unto glorification, and the power to take you in the kingdom without the help of any man. He alone can do all of that. You don't have to do anything more than receive Yahshua as the gift of life. For Yahweh gave Yahshua as a gift, the gift of eternal life. He says, not by works of righteousness that we have done, but by grace are we saved. Can you go to the Shabbat by upon that grace?
No.
Grace is unmerited favor. It's a gift. Do you work for a gift? What kind of contrariness in the world? They tell you that salvation is a gift, but you must come and do the works of the law. Isn't it called the work? Isn't it called the works of the law?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And there's a scripture that says the works are manifested, and it is called the works of the Lord. So if you are getting a gift, there's no need to do any works. You know, we're not going to get into that. Alright, you holding anything there?
Yes.
I just want to do that and then we're going to run.
Very quickly.
Yes.
This is Matthew 23, mm-hmm. verse 27.
Yes.
Go unto you, scribes and Pharisees, mm-hmm. hypocrites, for ye are like unto whitened sepulchres.
Yeah, whitened sepulchres.
They appear beautiful outward.
Yeah, they appear beautiful outward.
But are within full of dead men's bones.
That's what Yahshua was talking about. Their graves, the churches.
And of all uncleanness.
The same, and Yahweh says all your tables are full of vomit. Yes. Watch this vomit. Yahweh says that the Christian tables are full of vomit. Yeah. And the doctrine they are promoting is vomit. Listen, 2,000 years expired. Mm-hmm. And they take it down for you. You know what's vomit? Mm-hmm. If you're going every day and eat something that is expired, you know that vomit.
Yeah.
Why do people get sick all the time and
vomit?
They eat expired foods. So that's why, and they are standing in the pews. And there's a stench here, stink. You know why there's a stench? Yahweh said, I'll throw a dung upon your face.
Malachi chapter.
You think Yahweh played with them? Yahweh said, I'll throw. You know what dung is? Filth. So they're eating expired food. So they must be vomiting. And they have diarrhea, spiritual diarrhea too. So you can't just imagine if Yahweh should have opened their eyes to see the stench. Yeah, I say when you look in their houses, there's no place clean.
Yeah.
2,000 years expired food they're feeding the people. Alright. Job 32 and 8, you're holding that. What you're holding, Mitchell? I don't want anything that I didn't ask for. Because we're going to go in there. Job 32 and 8, there's a spirit in man. So our aim down here is to tell you about the spirit. How Yahshua is saving that spirit in man, not the flesh. Is concerned about the inner man. When you buy a box of orange juice, you're interested in your box, or you're interested in what is in the box.
What is in the box?
But the box, and the business is when you're in the box. The business is outside. What a stupidness. Huh? And he's looking at everything outside. I'm telling you that he's not interested about the soul. He's interested in the physical man. But listen to this scripture.
Job 32 verse 8.
Yes.
But there is a spirit in man.
Yahweh is concerned with that spirit. He said there is a spirit in man.
And the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding.
And he says the inspiration of the Almighty giveth this inner man understanding. So it's the ear tried words as the mouth tasted me. That's why when Yahshua prayed in the garden of Gethsemane, he said that this is life eternal that they might fool me. The only true element, Yahshua the Messiah, who the Lord said. And Yahshua said in the Bible in John 4, the hour cometh and now is when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Christendom tell you that is in the natural and in our life. The devil is an opposer. Well, you find out that according to the King James Version of the Bible, Lord God was revealed at the burning bush, because the children of Israel were 430 years in Egypt. And Yahushua went down and delivered them by the death of Allah. And they were buried in the divine water of the Red Sea, and they were resurrected in the wilderness. The new birth ascended to Canaan's land. And Moses received the name Yahweh Elohim and Yahushua at the burning bush right here. But when you read the King James Version, it says in Exodus 3:15, just jump to Exodus
3:15. Exodus 3:15, King James is ready.
Yes.
And God said moreover unto Moses.
So Moses and God is having a conversation, and notice on this side of the chart it says incorrect. We are proving to you that Lord is incorrect, God is incorrect, Jesus is incorrect, Christ is incorrect. Jack and Jehovah.
Read. Don't shall don't say unto the children of Israel.
No, he was speaking to Moses. And he says, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel,
the Lord God.
And he put the definite article there before. He said, the Lord God of your fathers.
The God of Abraham.
The God of Abraham.
The God of Isaac.
Yes.
The God of Jacob.
Yes.
And he sent me unto you.
Read.
This is my name forever.
Now look at this. This is simply new. And it's important to give Yahweh your undivided attention. Because you don't want. At that day, you didn't get something. Something might just miss you. And you don't get eternal rest. Because when Yahweh was speaking to you, you were paying attention. Now the King James Version of the Bible said, the Lord God is my name forever. Now,